Кулфаев! Рефери поединка Станислав Новицкий.
So this bantamweight contest is set to go underway. We look at the tail of the tape, height and reach, and we will say weight will be on the side of Nurburgen Sharipov. Kulayev will look to impose himself early in this fight. Kulayev in Tamerlan in the red corner, Nurburgen in the blue. Me, Brian Lacey, alongside Brad Pickett, calling the action here. ACA 111.
So much for you, see the Tamerlan. That headwind I was talking about.
That's hurt him. You can see he's struggling for breath, Brad. Turning sidekick right into the midsection. Nurburgen Sharipov understands the story of Tamerlan Kulayev, the rise of this young man, but he's not daunted by it. What an accurate and powerful kick that was, Brad.
Yeah, landed pretty good. You say, look, he's going for it again.
He looks huge, Brad. He looks in a completely different weight class when you see him side by side.
He looks like a lightweight, to be honest with you, Brian. It is a shame that he didn't make the weight. I hope that doesn't really become a factor within this fight.
We shall see. Nice long kick. Tamerlan Kulayev. Tamerlan, 28 years of age. This will be his 13th professional fight. Stayed very active in the last couple of years, used all that experience to grow as a fighter. Oh, that right hand though from Nurburgen.
Yeah, Nurburgen throwing a lot of heat with his hands and also that spinning back kick. Trying to look to do damage. It's the range that I think that Tamerlan's finding hard.
I was going to say exactly that. He's throwing up, but he's missing by a long way now. I'm trying to force this takedown.
This is where something where weight does pay a factor in when skill level's the same. It's going to be hard for him to get him down, especially in this position. Good. Sharipov, good defense here.
Sharipov stayed heavy with the hips, spread that base, and now he's forced Tamerlan to come back up. Little battle going on with the wrist fight in there, bro. What they're looking to do, obviously stop those punches coming over the top.
Yeah, it's
number one on the list.
What you want to try and do is sharp off, you try and get feed in that underhook, which he's just done now, and use that to try and turn him off. What Tamerlan's doing is actually found a few good little shots here. Good head position. This is the advantage of when you're a smaller fighter, you're up against the cage, your head just naturally is just in the right position.
Another short shot. You can feel how much effort they're doing, the breath, even just that you can hear their backs scraping across the cage here in the arena.
And what's impressive about this as well, Brian, you would have thought that Sharipov would have the size and the physical advantage, but it's really good pressure by Tamerlan to keep him up against it and do damage.
Yeah, good work indeed from Kulayev. Short shots coming in from each. Nice. Sharipov has made room for that knee as well.
A little bit of space now, chipping away at this body.
Looking for the single leg now, Kulayev trying to get into the mat, but look at the hips of Sharipov.
Yeah. Beautiful defense then. Going for the butt drag, going trying to go around to the back.
Holding on, cradling him, trying to pull him into his guard, but look at that, Kulayev aware of it, steps over.
Yeah, Kulayev really good wrestling, him managed to jump to the other side. A little bit of a battle here, Brian. A lot of scrambling going on.
And Kulayev has got to be, Sharipov has got to be careful. Oh, no, no, he's all right. He looked like he was about to give up his back.
Oh,
somehow they made space back to their feet. Just under a minute, 55 seconds to go in this round number one.
This round's still up for grabs as well, Brian.
Look at that. Sharipov able to shrug Kulayev against the fence. Kulayev, they're having to dig deep to make space. Double underhooks now. Oh, these are the trips I was talking about. Kulayev's wary of them, though.
They've done a good job of just trying to use that momentum to get down onto the legs, but Sharipov doing a good job of keeping a nice wide base. Stop him. Kulayev getting his hands together. Good little chip again. Some good scrambles going on here. Neither of them want to settle for a bad position.
That has been a fun first round between these two. Wow. Opened with that turning side kick to the midsection of Kolayev. And then a lot of grappling battling going on, Brad. A lot of small details that they're having to scrap for up against the cage, on the mat.
Yeah, we look back at that straight away, that spinning back kick that we believe hurt Kolayev. We made him run away a little bit. You used to see it. Oh, that's the higher. Was that the first one? Actually, wasn't in the body. We were first. I thought it was.
Yeah, absolutely.
It was actually partially bought by the hands. And then this whole round was a battle for position when neither one really wanted to settle for a bad position. So we saw some beautiful scrambles.
And you can tell both corners trying to get that lactic acid out of the muscles. They realize this is going to be a grueling battle between these two bantamweights.
This is the thing, you know that Sharapov missed weight, but we want to see, like, he missed though about 2 kilos, but how much did he
put back on,
yeah,
Brad?
But
that's
not,
the question.
That for one, but then also how hard was that? Did he just stop, not push his body too hard? Would he get fatigued, or did he just stop?
Yes, those questions we may find out as this fight unfolds. Round number two gets underway here in Moscow at ACA 111. Brogan Sharapov, blue corner. Tamerlan Kolayev in the red. Oof.
Managed to duck under that one. Kolayev now missed that spinning back fist. Got up against it. Now he's got a body lock, Brian, I believe. His hands locked. I say, with the height and the physicality, I thought that could possibly happen. Good little trip. You go around, try to go around the back. Like I say, Brian, this is textbook stuff, defensively and offensively.
Yeah, look, nice little trip attempt there to stifle the takedown. Oof.
Has a lock now. Could possibly go for a ride here.
Again, that wide base of Nürburgring. Oh, the mouthpiece is out.
That's the thing, though, when he's hardly, you're lifting him up, but his legs are still on the floor.
Oh, and that time he gets it to the mat.
It's a lot of effort, but is Sharapov going to accept this takedown? Is he accepting the position?
The referee is trying to feed.
Didn't want to accept the mouthpiece.
Yeah, well, he's a bit busy, I'd say, Brad. Maybe finding the right time to do that would be a little bit better. But nice word now to side control. Now the referee stops the action to allow the mouthpiece back in. Oh, it's the wrong mouthpiece.
Wrong person.
No wonder he didn't want it. I've already got one. Thanks, ref.
Offers and trying to sneak out the back door. Always going for an arm triangle, but he's getting caught inside guard here. Oh, he's getting passes. Can he pass?
And now he's reversed it. Scrappy stuff from these two again. It's all about the scrambles. This time, Bergen Sharapov now with Kolayev against the cage.
So some blood chipping out the left nostril of Kolayev.
Oh, trying to connect with those hooks. Trying another turning side kick. Kolayev steps out the way.
That one seemed a little bit more labored.
Ooh, a knee up the middle, though. And Kolayev is starting to wear some of that damage. Like you said, that nose is getting redder, bloodier.
Doing the right thing here, pushing forward, trying to negate the range, the length of Sharapov. Good drive.
Oh,
good
wow, can he finish it, Brad?
Piece of the neck here, Brian.
Oh, nice knee. Nice knee again. Kolayev. Working hard.
Yeah, Kolayev's digging deep.
2 minutes, 10 seconds. And the scrambles are unreal in this round in particular.
Also, it's very draining on the gas tank. Neither of them really giving an inch. Going to be a lot of test on their condition. Going into the third round, if we get there, 2 minutes left in round number two.
Yeah, that's the question, will that weight cut of Sharapov, will that cause any problems with this round, as these rounds go on? Now they're both again digging to their midsection.
Shading shots to the body.
One for one.
finish. You just see, mate, it's like knee.
Oh,
ooh, good little turn away now.
Oh, Sharifa. Oh, he's trying to finish that. He could have given up his back here, though, Brad.
One hook in-ish. That's it, just not scrambling. Fighting hands, doing a great job here. Stopping Malaya getting his hands locked. Oh, fighting the grip again.
Yep. Looking for that Kimura now. Yep. See if he drops for this, and he has. See if he'll roll that over. A lot of effort going on there.
Yeah, he's trying to use that.
He might get this sweep as well. You can see Kalaev has got both his hands gripped, trying to stop that.
He's put himself in kind of half guard position. He's abandoned that.
Oh, and again, though.
It's scrappy sort of stuff there. People losing positions.
Warned against the fingers in the cage. Not once, but twice there by the referee, Kalaev. Got to be careful, because this is such a close fight. You don't want that to factor into any decision.
Exactly that, Brian. Losing a point in a 10-9, in a 10-point round.
Oh, he's hurt him there.
The body as well.
And again, he just misses with that. He keeps going for that, Brad, and it's this battle again and again.
Yeah, what he does, he's giving his back. And oh!
You heard the effort there, Brad.
It was. He landed in a bad position. I say the pressing scrambles. But I say the crane has so much scrambles. It's not just one, that one's not accepting the position, but two, also a little bit of, like I say, lacking technique in certain areas where they're not controlling their opponent as much as they should do.
And what a back and forth round that was. Two rounds in the books, 10 minutes down.
Yeah, looking into both corners now to see who looks fresher or two. Looking back into some of the action, there's a struggle of that, getting that takedown, but it was just impressive how Sharapov, both of them never really settled for a bad position, just create scramble after scramble after scramble. That's that knee to the body that did do a bit of damage.
Boy, he just missed with that, and he kept coming with those spinning back fists as well, which arguably put him in more of a bad position than the work he was doing more fundamentally well.
Yeah, I mean, like, I think now the timing of it, when you're going to see that Sharapov loves a spinning move, it's a spinning back kick or a spinning back fist. With doing so, you're taking your eyes off your opponent. Now, Holayev is kind of reading that a little bit and closing the gap and getting around to his back. Round number three, Brian.
Third and final round. 5 minutes to make their mark. This bantamweight contest. Sharapov in the blue corner. Kalaev in the red. And again, he's giving up this back position early. Look at the effort Kalaev is trying to put in. He's going to give it up.
Yeah.
He's in trouble himself now.
And he's trying to take away the shorts as well. Shorts are kind of coming up a little bit. I think they're okay in position now.
They're all good, and Sharapov is now trying to work to the back. But it's these bits, Brad. No one is able to establish a position. Someone will get a takedown, and then after that, a scramble happens. They're back to their feet. They've got to work again. Nobody's been able to have a dominant position for more than maybe 10 seconds of the fight.
That's the thing, isn't it? Like Sharapov is going for a spinning move and constantly giving up his back. And Holayev is getting the back, but not really been able to muscle him down, scrub down. Really good balance by Sharapov, and actually create some crazy sort of scrambles, as we've been seeing throughout this whole fight.
Oh, nice head movement there from Holayev.
Good shot there.
Yeah, lovely stepping over and right.
Just love it when it gets into the third round and someone hits a clean shot. You see all the sweat fly off the head.
Our slow motion cameras would have caught that, obviously. Kalaev trying to stalk Sharapov, trying to time him. Maybe both are just taking a gentleman's breather here. Oof.
Yeah, fatigue definitely playing a factor in both of them, to be honest. That's the thing, though, when you have one of those scrambling sort of fights, both tussling for position, it does take a lot. Now the cardio, good little clean right here by Sharapov.
Oh. Again, Kalaev just struggling with that range, getting inside those long limbs of Sharapov.
Just want to think how long I'm going to wait for Sharapov to do a spinning move.
Oh, nice. Look at that, Brad. Timed that takedown. turned it around, but again, Kalayev finds a way back to his feet, and we're working from this position up against the cage. And as I say that, Sharipov turns it around.
Yeah, this is grueling to watch here, Brian. Good job, he's trying to get his double unders here. Also, when you get to the third and final round, sweat plays a big factor in these sort of positions.
Oh, yeah. Nice knee. That sounded brutal as it hit the midsection there of Kalayev. Solid poker face, though, from the Vladikavkaz fighter.
Yeah, sometimes there's the ones where land and sound really bad, don't do much. He's a good knees here. He's doing it again. He's targeting now, I think, Brian. Oh. Both corners being very vocal, knowing this is a very close fight.
Yeah, they worked so hard rounds. Oh, that has taken his base away. Chopped him down like a tree, Brad, and now can he work to the back?
He took that, you know, great opportunity.
Oh, too high up.
Yeah, again, Brian, he saw crazy sort of scrambles.
Oh, he's got like a reverse triangle, but no arm trapped in there, Brad. Just literally scissoring the head. Yes. Nürburgring gets it out, back to his feet.
Yeah, I mean, a little bit of both ways. Like, good scramble, but also, like, not very good control. He jumped on the back, got too keen, was way too high, and slipped right off. So, like I said, when coming to the third round, sweat plays a big factor in it. And in such a close fight, you can't really afford to lose these sort of positions.
And now, Kalayev trying to add a bit more pressure, maybe feeling he has to do something in his last minute. 1 minute, 4 seconds to make that mark.
Good little timing there, Sharipov, his timing and coming in. We saw earlier, kick with that low calf kick, kicked the base off earlier, and tried again just then.
Clock is ticking. 45 seconds. He's going to struggle to finish this from here, right, Brad?
Yeah, he was trying to go for ankle pick, I believe. He's trying to take the weight off that leg, which he hasn't done. Maybe when he try to go around to the back. His left arm stopping.
He's almost, yeah, blocked himself there.
Maybe go around, come up, go around to the back, maybe.
20 seconds. Sharipov just staying heavy on the upper back, the back of the neck here of Kalayev.
Yeah, he's coming up now.
Maybe we'll see it when that 10 seconds comes in. Oh, a nice knee.
Spinning move, maybe. No, clash of heads instead.
Yeah, a little bang of heads there. Both took it. Sharipov trying to make a statement at the end of this third and final round. Wow. This. Another close fight, both of them putting it on the line. I don't know what's going on backstage at ACA 111, but every single fight so far has been a spectacle to watch. Really technically good. Another great bit of matchmaking here between these two bantamweights. And Brad, look at, there's the low kick that took his base away.
I mean, this is a close one to call. Both fighters believe they've done enough. You saw that. He's heavy on that leg. And that's when he got swept away from. But then got too overzealous and tried to get the take the back and just fell off. And then we landed in his, like I said, this fight for me has all been about scrambles. You know, and you can just see how fatigued both of these are because of the constant scrambling. But it's very, for me, it's a very, very close fight. Both of them believe they've done enough. Both, at the end of the round, both of them raised their hands. But
we will see.
Let's make
rounds.
This one official to see which one it goes.
And you see in the corner, Madabek Kadaginov. In the corner there of Tamerlan Kalayev, a real gem of a fighter himself and a personality. But it's time now to find out who took the victory. We hand it to RMC.
Дамы и господа, по завершении трехраундного боя единогласным решением судей победу одержал боец из синего угла Туркмен Шарипов, Казахстан. И аплодисменты его сопернику из Владикавказа Тамерлану Кулаеву.